if I die in West Virginia, toss me in a landmark landfill. But if I die in Memphis, won't you sprinkle me on Bill? That's where I wanna be in my afterlife, hanging out with furries, ghosts, and dancing in the lights. Seeing all the people coming from near and far, wanting to hear something authentic, but it's Limp Bizkit in the bar. And it makes you want to puke, and you want to look at them coyote broads. You want to tell them get the hell on out and take it back west, bruh, cause we want Beale Street back. We want it back, want it back. And if we gotta take it when we're ghosts, that'll be just fine. We will haunt your fucking asses till the end of time. If I die in West Virginia, toss me in a landmark landfill. But if I die in Memphis, won't you sprinkle me on Beale?
Barbara.
if you live that long. Jalapeno cornbread. Then he's gonna make some fresh from the farm bacon and put it between some cornbread. Put it between some cornbread, and it will accentuate a big old pot of pickle beans that's been soaking for 2 days. Yeah, yeah. Jalapeno cornbread. Jalapeno cornbread. Jalapeno cornbread. Jalapeno cornbread. Jalapeno cornbread. Thank you. wearing purple fuzzy cuffs. No need for safe word, cause everyone's getting fucked. Yeah, baby in Rooster. Baby in Rooster. Baby in Rooster. Baby in Rooster. Craigslist is filled with killers and pervs. You can live out your nightmares if you get up the nerve. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Baby and Rooster, night out on town. Baby and Rooster, get back to the house. Baby and Rooster, gonna wear that silk blouse. Yeah. Rooster's into all kinds of stuff. She's got appendage hardware, he got the purple cuffs. Yeah, no need for a safe word, we're all getting fucked. Yeah, baby and Rooster. Baby and Rooster. Here's a real deal story. A real deal American who's salt of the earth and top of his line, doing his thing. Let me talk about him. Well, he's a veteran and he's in real, real, real good shape. He's a down to earth, street level bro. Extra lip, unlike that other mother. He's got real steady hands, a sketchy white band, and he plays a mean game of billiards. Cooks so good, oh man, that food is fire. Better put on some flame retardant attire. Let's talk about a good old salt of the earth, old man. He's got two dogs the size of linebackers. Sells cars on the side when he's not helping other veterans. I'm telling you, man, this cat, he sure is a solid dude. You won't catch him in no karaoke bar getting blue. Cause he's a solid cat. Yelling.
Tidra, 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 Tidra. I don't know why I am. I don't know why the abyss stares back. I don't know why I can't get together. I don't know why. Used to think I was the existentialist. I used to think I was an absurdist. I used to think that I was a realist. I used to think that I was a nihilist, a doubtist, a Buddhist. Jesusist.
Place in hell for people just like you who suck it, just like you who suck it, suck it, suck it, suck it. You ruined the scene with your fucking ego. Motherfucker, suck my dick. Motherfucker, suck my dick. It ain't my place to tell you how to fix it. Motherfucker, suck my dick. Motherfucker, suck my dick. I'm so tired of people telling me what I'm supposed to do with my music. Motherfucker, suck my dick. No, I don't care to learn more than fucking four chords. Motherfucker, suck my dick. Motherfucker, suck my dick. You Your kids are half ignorant and your girl is cross-eyed. Motherfucker, suck my dick. Motherfucker, suck my dick. You think everyone cares about your plans? No one shows up but your motherfucking mom and her new man. I've only got one piece of advice. Motherfucker, suck my dick. Motherfucker, suck my dick. You can tell your kids that you gave fellatio to the fucking great slave dump. The fucking great slave dump. And now you will finally have a legacy. When I was 12 years old, started out shoveling snow and raking leaves. Before I knew it, I got me a lawnmower. Thought this is all I'll ever need. By the time I turned 18, I started working in the service sector. Cleaning bathrooms and making sandwiches, I thought this is what life was. By 23, my aunt said, hey, you're wasting your life. Go to college, cause you're one of the smartest, sharpest in the drawer of knives. So I got myself some loans and I went to school. Didn't have a rich family, so I ended up being played for a fool. 5 years later, and 3 degrees, I was working at a mental health place for barely enough to eat. Same as I was 18 was the same as when I was 27. If I got enough money to keep my car on the road and to give me some girls, well, that's pure heaven. But all that shit, it just left me dry and cold. I was a good boy and always tried to do as I was told. I started living by my own set of rules. So I started to pick up my grandma's old 1960 model Gibson. Plugged a two-channel mixer into the back of an old Windows 95 computer. I started making songs just for shits and giggles. And now look at me, y'all. I'm fucking for pickles with a side of sandwich. But for real, in 2005 is when I started my musical journey. I was so crazy and out of it, you could have called an ER to bring me a gurney. In just under a week, I had recorded enough for about 3 albums. Just a blues boy doing what I can in a hard, cold land. Trying to prove to people that I didn't have to, that I was a man. Oh, I was such a ham. friends say I like what you got there. Why don't you put some songs up on the MySpace? And I got on there and took a couple pictures of my old ugly face. They said we really like what you're doing, we really like your songs. If we come to America, would you mind if we tagged along? And they did. It took 6-7 years. But all those folks who said they wanted to record with me ended up recording with me. All those folks who said they wanted to tour with me ended up touring with me. Self-determination. And then in early 2009, I found another woman. Made me lose my focus. I didn't know if I was coming or going. I was still recording though. But I wasn't as hard at it. People said I was making devil music. So I started incorporating gospel songs just to offset all my devil songs. But still, that wasn't enough for everybody. So I did what I pleased. Put that model band of world down on its knees. Very happy to say I had some modestly successful music fucking festivals under my belt. It means a lot to me. The performers that came and played, and people come to hear, you know. I didn't feel like I was doing something. I was a productive member of society. A couple years after that, I got 2 t-shirts at the West Virginia Music Hall of Fame. Can't walk down the streets of Memphis without somebody yelling out my name. Talking about, hey Neffy, hey Neffy, hey Neffy, hey Neffy, hey Neffy, hey Neffy, where you playing at next? Probably at the Buccaneer or Murphy's or wherever else. Make a long story short, I had 40 artists in 8 different countries cover my songs. They recorded them too and put them on some albums so other people could sing along. I've been on satellite radio and terrestrial radio over in Scotland. On podcasts all over Brazil and Germany and even Japan. Achieved all of this without the use of a press kit. Cause I'm a hard working, dirty son of a bitch. I put in work. I put in work. I put in work. I put in work.
Yeah.
From the hard, dark shards of rain, this will always remain the same. So many things left unsaid. I wished you were nicer to me, and you wished I was dead. How can you prove something you didn't do? Said this has all been long overdue. Put everything you own out in your truck. Said where you go, I don't give a fuck. And that was ice cold, ice cold. I still wish things were different. I wish things were all the same. And upon my dying lips, I'll gently whisper your name. Roll out them slicey boys, line up all the docks. All the ones who prescribe opiates, their prescriptions have got to stop. Shoot you an opiate dealer, shoot them right in the face. Won't someone come and help us clean up this place? Shoot you a heroin dealer, shoot them right in the eye. Shoot a heroin dealer before the last ones of us die. Shoot you an opiate dealer, put their soul up in the sky. Come on everybody, opiate dealers need to die. I've lost my best friend forever, and I'm never getting him back. I've lost my best friend forever, and I'm never getting him back. Should at least stick to dealing marijuana, or at least acid and crack. But if you wanna deal opiates, I hope you get shot in your back. Square in their neck.